September 2008 that struck the city of Ljubljana. And we can say that the earthquake marked the city of this marked the city because the city of Ljubljana is situated in one of the territory with higher seismicity of the entire peninsula, and since its foundation has been struck several times by the earthquake. In fact, the first earthquake, which is historically documented, dates back to December 1315. And another strong earthquake occurred on September 9th of 1349 and was rated 6.5 magnitude, and that produced damage to comparable to the 10 position in that Mercalli's scale. And another time was destroyed by another seismic swarm in the 16th century. In addition to this, we can say that to understand how much destroyed the city after the earthquake, we study it was structure. As for this reason, we can say that Ljubljana is had a historic center, and this historic center is situated on a hill raised above the surrounding basin, and from the ancient time present compact and enclosed between medieval walls. And at first breath of the perimeters of the city, we come with the construction of sport installation of the Gran Sasso during the 14th. And the urban expansion as development since 16th and 17th followed the opening of the highway from Rome to Pescara, and its subsequent development as occurred since from the historic center and involving all around in all directions, except to the southwest where the Adamo riders. And after the last earthquake, a lot of building in the historic center was destroyed. And for this reason, we highlight the perimeter of the so-called the red area, the red zone, is represented the area still forbidden for the citizen, for the public. And we can see is many building is destroyed completely. And the aim of this work is we want through the use of historical map to find the date of construction of individual building in the city of Ljubljana. And in order to improve dating of the building, those built after the 1930 and for the 1930 and those built after the 1940. Because between the 1913 and 1914, the building methodologies change deeply. We want also to investigate if there is a correct correlation between the building methodologies and damage suffered by the building. For this reason, this work was considered a 1-2000 historic map that represented the center of the city, and this map is undated. And for this reason, we try to figure out what years it is, and we look the layout of the map, and we can say that we hypothesize that it was drawn between the 1913 and the 1914 century, are just the years when the building methodologies change. So map usually suffered geometric deformation during the conservation and acquisition, and this map is not georeferencing. For this reason, to make a georeference is usually no point and polymatic to on the resulting raster file. But in our case, a GPS surveys campaign was performed because there was no modern map with an accuracy comparable to the historical map. And this is a very hard job. Because for two reasons. Because first of all, fault coverage of the historical center, GPS signal doesn't reach our point. And secondly, we can say that the historical center is forbidden, still forbidden for the citizen. And we use QGIS, and in QGIS we can show the algorithm of the geodancing, and we choose the third order polynomial, because we think that this transformation surely manages the deformation due to eventually this eventually different reaction. And we collect 27 GPS points, and we can see their distribution in this area. We obtain the result and here represented, and we can see the residual ground control point, increase till to stabilization, while residual checkpoint it's presented a peak. And we can say that it's very strange, but we looking for an error, we looking for that it's a wrong point, and we checked if a 1 to 5,000 map is a more near GPS point than geodetic raster map. We see better. And this is true on all points investigated, and so conclude there is no gross miscalculation of the coordinate of the point. So here is represented the map of fitness for human habitation. This map was made during the first emergency period, followed the last earthquake, and establish if the building struck of the earthquake can be used without risking human life. And we can see the represented a different class: building usable, building temporarily unusable, but usable for some investigation, building temporarily unusable to investigation partner, building partially unusable, and the class A and F is building unusable for structural or geodetic risk, and for due to serious external risk. So we overlapping the map of fitness for human habitation and historical map. We can and historical map. Can distinguish between new buildings and the old buildings. The old buildings, we say the historic center, but now buildings, the around the historic center. After the 16 building, between 16 and 17. So we want to show some of the buildings destroyed by the earthquake, like the government palace and the Casa dello Studente. And so with QGIS was then possible to vectorize the polygons according to the classification, and we can see the old buildings vectorized with the polygon and the new building. So we can see distribution of the damage. And new building after the earthquake are largest classified in class A, and unlike those of the old buildings are classing with E, with A and parting on F. So we can say that the conclusion and further development that through the availability of other large scale map, it will be possible to improve the dating of the buildings for to find a date, to find the material that used in this period. Thus, will help to evaluate if exists the effect of the different legislation of construction ad hoc.